Saturday, it's 9:15. We are live and kicking, so please give a big hand, and there is one, for your hosts, Miss Emma Ledden, hello, and Steve Wilson!
Show this morning, haven't we?
Yes, we have. Stay with us until 12:15 this morning. We've got some incredible guests. The Starfest to beat all Starfest. Emma, who's on the show?
Live in the studio, we've got Westlife.
Westlife!
There's also the legend, Miss Diana Ross.
Wow!
Fountains in the house.
Oh, yes. We've got those three lovely honeys, everyone.
She is here live in the studio performing her hit single. She's flown all the way from the States. Ooh. It is the Queen of Pop, Miss Britney Spears, everybody. Yeah. Britney Spears.
Welcome to Live and Kicking. Welcome to the UK.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me here.
That's good.
Can I have a kiss as well?
Oh, yeah, sure. Hey, there you go. Is it good to see? Is it good to see you? No, you can't, Mitch. You're behind the door.
I want a kiss from Britney.
Is it good to see UK fans?
Definitely. Oh my goodness. Yeah, they're so sweet.
Really? Oh, they're all over there. Give them a wave. Woo! There you go. Excellent. You're sticking around for part of the morning, aren't you? Fantastic. And you've got
something. Yes, well, as well as you being here this morning, you've also got an exclusive Britney Spears competition. We've got not one, not two, but three Britney Spears dolls.
Look at that.
Yes. You're going to tell us all about them later on. Exclusive. Not available in Europe anywhere.
Oh, no.
Just went on sale in America yesterday, so three to give away later on.
Fantastic. You're also going to be taking calls as well, aren't you? So if you want to speak to Britney, you'd be mad if you wouldn't, then give us a call on this number right now.
4, 5, 6, 1, 0, 1, 5, 1, 5.
Welcome to the show. Oh, yes, excellent. And right now, someone else who also drives us crazy, but in a completely other way. Mitch?
Yes.
Tell us what's on the show, mate.
I'm a crazy, bonkers kind of guy. Thank you, Steve. I want that kiss next. Now, we're festooned, actually, today with top showbiz babes. Emma Bunton has a new single out with Tintin out, and she's on her way into Tellyland. From babes to babies, three episodes coming up of the rambunctious Rugrats. As you saw there, we got to actually two baby Furbies and three Britney Spears dolls to give away. I'm going to get her to sign them for you as well. Our friendly little alien, Malcolm, will help you clunk the junk at 9:50. Then, sweet and yummy, the Honeyz are buzzing by for a cozy chat. We can talk to them later. You just seen her in all her glory, and you can call her too. Britney Spears will be here live on the telephones later. And also that clever chappy, smart guy. He gets musical and gets funky on Live and Kicking. Westlife are winging their way here to sing their latest track, Flying Without Wings. And the soul diva herself, the legend that is Diana Ross, is here with a brand new single. And as if we weren't busy enough, we need you on the phones as well. Here's the number.
08456101515.
That's our phone number. You can call us and come on the telly.
08456101515.
I have to say, what an amazing show. Haven't we got an amazing show?
Yes.
Britney Spears, Westlife, the Honeyz, Emma Bunton.
Yeah, hey, don't forget Diana Ross, yeah? Miss Ross, miss out, yeah? Miss Ross. Letters.
Thank you so much for all your letters. We just got sack loads of letters.
Sack loads of letters.
Much.
Yes, again. This one here is from Kevin, who's in Edinburgh. Hello, Kevin. Kevin says, I've got to go to South Africa on Monday. Very nice, too.
Lovely.
Kevin says, you may think that's good, but I've also got tickets to see Steps in concert. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to miss the concert of a lifetime. So, please say goodbye to my friend Claire. That's from Kevin. So, Kevin, I think, you know, Steps, that would have been fantastic. But South Africa, come on.
We're going to play their video later on in the show, Steps.
There you go. And enjoy South Africa. I'm sure it's very nice.
Indeed. All right, now, I have a gorgeous letter. It says, Dear Emma and Steve, and everyone sit comfortably and listen to this. I am writing to you from the very, very bottom of my heart. I'm writing to ask you to convey my truest feelings to a girl I know. I really, really like her and know she feels the same for me. We first met on a train where I instantly fell for her, and I've seen her on the train every day since. I talk to her often, but I've never had the courage to ask her out. Listen to this, we have pet names for each other. She likes to call me Biggles, and I call her my hippo.
That's
so sweet. Her friends have assured me that she also likes me, but also does not have the courage to ask me out. So that's why I've decided to make the first move. What I will ask of you is that you will please say this for me. Okay, cool. Listen carefully at home. Ruth Kaywood, if you are out there, I really, really like you. This is not me talking about you. I would like to go out with you. Will you all? You will always be my little hippo from your loving Biggles.
Isn't that nice?
Isn't that lovely?
So there you go. It's now been done, hasn't it?
It's now been done.
And I tell you what, you must let us know. Write to us. Let us know the turnout of this. What happens? Let us know.
Yeah. But even better, if you can get each other today, try if you're Ruth's friend or if you're Biggles' friend, get in contact, get them together and try and ring in the show.
Yes, give us a call. Let us know what happens.
Make a love match.
Oh, yes, a love match. That's a nice match. Letter to start the morning with, I think. Do keep your letters coming into the usual address. Here it is. Live and Kicking, PO Box 8181, London W12.
6L8.
Yes, indeed. Yes.
What this is for you.
Is that? Can you see that just there?
Maggots.
Hang on. That can mean one of two things, you see. That either means lunch has come early. Which I don't think it has, or it means it's now time for fishing for compliments.
Richard?
I prefer when we just do
instead of just a wishing.
Hello. Hello, everybody, and welcome to another fishing. I'm not doing. I always do this. You slacker. You start the piece. Go on.
For goodness' sake, don't throw to me. You'll confuse the vision mixer.
Oh, not the lovely Sue. Sorry, Sue. I'm so sorry. Marry me. Marry me.
Oh, for goodness' sake! No, save yourself, Sue. Come back to me. Good idea. Way ahead of the game. Yes, it's time once again for fishing for compliments. And on the show this morning, we have the lovely Britney Spears.
Hey!
Oh yes, the most babe-licious pop star at the moment, I would say. And oh, for goodness' sake, look at me. I'm already giving you compliments, and we haven't even started the game.
That's right. You're very free, aren't you?
I am. Fool to myself.
No, you're under crackers. I think you're very. What? You just sort yourself out.
Oh, for goodness' sake. Oh,
sorry, Britney.
Sorry. Britney. I had to pull them back up.
You're so young, aren't you?
It's the sweat.
So rich, so lovely. So marry me! Marry me, please!
Oh, for
marry
goodness
me.
Sake, Britney, I'm sorry. I'll apologise on behalf of my brother. He's 500 years old. He's desperate, I tell you. No, wait a minute. That came out wrong. He's not that desperate. You're babelicious. You're gorgeous.
And oh, thank you.
I'm complimenting you again. We haven't even started the game.
Yes, who was it once said? If you don't get this done in 4 minutes, you're off the ship. Oh, no, that was somebody else. Come on, let's press on.
Let's move
do
on.
It. Come
the
on.
Game is very, very simple. Oh, yes. You've got 30 seconds on the clock to do the fishing, and we stop the clock when you've actually hooked a question or a compliment.
Okay.
Obviously, the whole point of the game is to get more compliments than questions. So, okay. Brittany, let's get the fishes swimming.
Fishy,
here
fishy.
Come the fishies.
They swam and they swam.
And cast off.
Oh.
Now, we've changed the hook this week to make it easier.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, that's it. Come put
it on.
Give that to me, brother.
Oh,
give it to me, brother.
Okay.
Give it to me, brother.
Can I unhook it? There we are.
Well
it's,
done.
It's a question.
Excellent.
Okay. Do you know Wheezy Anna?
What?
A friend of ours, Wheezy Anna.
Oh, Wheezy
what's that all about, Brittany?
Do I know who?
Wheezy Anna?
Louisiana?
I think Louisiana.
Louisiana?
Okay, yes, that's where I'm from.
No kidding, whereabouts?
And New Orleans.
Is it a big one? Is that a big place?
Well, actually, I live like an hour away from New Orleans. It's called Kentwood, Louisiana. It's a really, really small town.
Small town.
Yeah,
oh, very
small.
Did you get back there? Did you go back a lot?
Yeah, actually, today I'm going back and I get to see my family and my little sister, so I'm excited.
Lord, how long is that going to take?
Fantastic.
10 hours.
Oh, what?
We'd best press on, brother.
That's about as long as this game.
Stop going. We've got 21 seconds on the clock. Get us another one.
Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's for me.
We've got a plane to catch here.
That's a purple one, and oh, this is a question as well. Okay, now, I know it's very rude to ask a lady her age, but how old are you now?
I'm 17.
17, ladies and gentlemen, 17, and such a huge star and a huge success.
Oh,
but
thank you.
What would you like to be doing, where would you like to be, when you're 40?
When I'm 40?
Oh, yeah. What sort of question is
that? I would like to probably live in Louisiana.
And back home?
Yeah, back home, because I'm such a family person. I love being close to my family, so I couldn't live far away from my family. And probably, hopefully by then, have like 3 kids and a husband.
Ooh,
and
nice.
Still be singing.
Fantastic. Got your eye on anyone in particular in the husband stakes?
Huh?
Got any your eye on anybody in particular in your husband stakes?
Me! No. Me!
Oh, for goodness sake, brother!
Me.
Let's start fishing! Start the clock!
Come on, you've got how many seconds? Oh, what, 15 seconds?
Okay.
15.
Here you go.
Do
oh, there's
one.
Give that to me, brother. Give that to him.
Okay.
Oh, here we are. It's always the devils to get off here.
They are, aren't they?
What does it say here? Something crashed into the billboards. What was that? Something crashed into the billboards.
Oh, dear, that sounds nasty.
Oh, there, try again. Start the clock. Come on, with a few seconds. Let's get another one.
Oh, yeah, another one? Okay.
You can manage another one.
Okay.
This one?
Did that didn't have one. Oh. That didn't have one. Oh!
Yay. Oh, that's a strange looking one.
Oh, I say, tell you. And this one is a compliment, Brittany. It's a compliment.
Oh, it is.
And it says, nice legs.
That's very nice.
There you go. That's short and sweet, isn't it?
Yeah, that's
listen,
very sweet.
I'd like to say a great big thank you to Britney Spears. Give her a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
We're being moved on here.
Yes, we're being moved on.
Yeah, that was 4 seconds count for nothing.
Brittany.
Yeah.
Can I get just a little kiss? I missed out at the top of the show.
Get out of it. Well, there we go. It's time to say goodbye from the only game show on TV with sick bags. Big thanks to Brittany. We'll see you next time.
On Fishing for Compliments. Bye-bye.
I couldn't read what was on the thing.
We've got your number.
Do you know what? I think Brittany enjoyed kissing the leprechauns more than she did me just then. Anyway, this is that time of morning for you to be sat on the edge of your sofa because we have got your number. We've got a number in here. We're going to surprise someone very shortly. First of all, we've sent our hit squad to somewhere in the UK. Let's check. Is Otis in position? Are you there? Are you there, Otis? Are you on this screen? Please?
There he is. Look, he's popped up.
Oh, where are you? Otis, where... You... I'm going to be quiet, okay. You're in a kitchen. Whose kitchen? Oh, you're in a... Oh, I see, right. I get it, Otis, mate. Okay, yep, so... Yep, nice mug, by the way. So, you're in a DIY store in Chester. So, we be in a DIY store in Chester, and...
Cue.
That should give
Q
you the
Steve.
Cue to guess where you are. So, we be in a store in Chester, and that should give you the cue to guess where we are. There you go. Now then, take a look at your... I think we've got that. I've just been told in my ear. Take a look at your screens right now.
Send them a bill for advertising.
This person here on your screens right now, this is David Mogg, who is from Chester. He's the biggest DIY fan ever, and his biggest hero is, in fact, Changing Rooms Handy Andy. Now, he's gone shopping with his mum and dad to supposedly buy a new woodwork saw, and we persuaded him to take part in a special jigsaw demonstration that we've set up elsewhere in the store. Of course, that's all part of the setup because David thinks that he's being filmed for an in-store promotional video, when in fact what he doesn't know is that he is actually live on BBC One. How about that? He is in fact live on BBC One. So I'm now going to open the silver envelope because there's a number in here. It's actually his dad, John, who has stood just next to him. It's his mobile number. So let's give him a ring and let's surprise David. Here we go. Thank you. Mitch, this is the bit where you say something funny while I do this.
Something funny? Let me think. Utterly something funny. My life's in ruins.
Really?
I'm an archaeologist. Ha ha. There you go. Joke of the day.
Thank you, mate. I think that's just about filled the time I need.
I've only got one joke this week. That's it.
Here we go.
I've got to say hello to my friend Tony Ashton very quickly. Get well soon, Tony. I'll fill a second.
Here we go. This is his dad's mobile.
Hello.
Hello. Is that John?
Yeah, speaking.
Hiya, John. It's Steve here.
Yeah.
Is it possible to speak to David?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Hang on a minute, David. David, somebody on the phone, please. I don't know who it is.
Hello. Is that David?
Yeah.
David, hello. It's Steve Wilson here. You're live on Live and Kicking on BBC One. Good morning, David. Do you know, we know all about you and your obsession with woodwork and with DIY, and I'll tell you why, because your sister, you've got a sister, haven't you? Yeah? And she's called Charlotte.
Yeah.
And your sister Charlotte wrote to us saying, listen to this. Charlotte said, my little brother David loves making things, and for his birthday, all he wanted was woodworking equipment, and he was thrilled when his mum and dad got him his own hammer. So far, he's made a picture frame and also a bird table as well. Is that right? Yeah? Yeah. You've made a bird table. Excellent. And there's a picture here. Have you got a screen near you? Have you got a TV screen near you?
Yeah.
There's a picture here. This is the picture that you drew of your sister Charlotte. That's cool. Is that what she looks like?
Yeah.
Yeah? It is. And also, I've got something else next to me here. Keep looking at your screens. You made this, didn't you, David?
Yeah.
Look at that. Look, come on, crew. What do you think? That's brilliant.
Fantastic.
That's the bird table that you made. You're obviously very, very handy, aren't you? Now, can you do me a favour? You've got a shop assistant, I think, next to you. I think you've got a shop assistant next to you. He looks a little bit dodgy. He looks a bit shifty. If you look at him, he's got a few things to say to you. I'll leave you with him. It's our man of the morning, Otis. I'll leave you with him.
How you doing, David? You all right? Yeah, you're nervous now, or you're cool? You're a bit nervous, all right? Well, don't worry, because what you have to do now is relax. Because over the next 2 hours, we're going to give you the opportunity live to show us exactly what you can do with your woodwork skills. All right? So look, we've got loads of tools here for you. All right? You've got 2 hours to make something. All right? Away you go. Okay. Maybe that was a bit unfair. Okay? Do you reckon you need some help? Yeah? Okay, right. So we need someone who's really good with wood.
Yeah.
Okay? Someone who can bend and mold wood to their whim. Someone, no, who can we ask? Let's have a look around. Is there anyone about? Let's have a look. Come round here. Follow me round here. I'll tell you what, why don't you ask that geezer there if he'll give you a hand? Oh, sorry.
Excuse me, mister.
It's Handy Andy.
Hello, young man. How you doing?
Look, this is a shocked person.
Hero.
I understand Hero. From a little person that you actually built a fantastic bird table, is this true?
Yeah.
And I understand you're a dab hand with the old woodworking tools, and also that you are going to teach me how to build something. Is this true?
Yeah.
good man.
What we're going to do now, Steve, is we got some things to take care of here in Chester, you know, man's things. We got to do some sawing, some hammering, you know, some gluing, you know, some screwing. So y'all come back to us in about an hour and a half and see how we're getting on, okay?
Fantastic, thanks Otis. You get on with your man things. You get on with your man things. I'm going to get on with some woman things now. We'll catch up with them a bit later. I'm going to get up some woman things with some two lovely ladies up in the phone area, I think.
Thank you, Steve. Yes, I am here in the phone area with the phone team. Big wave, everybody.
Hey. Hello, phone team.
And our newest addition to the phone team, Miss Britney Spears. First fishing and now phones. Are you enjoying yourself this morning?
Yes.
Who are you chatting to?
I'm talking to your name, Natalie.
And what is her question for you?
Her question is, when my next single is going to come out?
will come out in January.
Brilliant. And of course, you will be taking calls and questions later on, answering more. So if you would like to talk to Britney Spears and ask her a question, bring us on our usual number. 0845 610 1515. Now, you weren't very quick with that one, I tell you. Thank you, Brittany. We'll talk to you later on. Okay, right now it's time to head to Email Corner. To find out who our winners on the web are this week. And Steve is here. Hello, Steve.
I'm here. Hello.
How you doing?
I'm very well.
How's Brittany?
Brittany, she's very well. Look, have a little wave.
Hello, hello. She's over there. Anyway, time for your winners. Winners on the web. We've had so many Rugrats pictures. Thanks to everyone who sent them in. You can see a load of them here, plastered up on our wall. And we have chosen our three favourites, haven't we, for this week?
Winners on the web.
And in fact, let's have a look at them now. Come on, we're going to look at them on the web. There they are in small. Let's have them in big, shall we? There you go. Check it out. That is Angelica. That's been sent in by Katrina Mowat, who is from Bromley. Isn't that cool?
Brilliant.
Next one.
Our second winner on the web.
There we go.
Right one. It does. It comes from Philippa Doherty from Quinton in Birmingham.
And that's Susie as well. That's a picture of Susie. And our final winner on the web, I think, is that Chucky or is that Chris Evans?
No, it's Chucky.
Daniel Springford, who is from High Wycombe, has sent that one in. Excellent. Well done to you three. You are our winners on the web. Yeah. They will be up there for a whole week, so check it out at the usual website address.
And keep sending in your pictures because we'll, of course, have three more winners on the web next week. But right now, it's time for our very first Rugrats of the morning, and Tommy is becoming the man of the house. Go say hello.
You're watching Live and Kicking. Miss it, miss out.
The absolutely gorgeous David Beckham will be on the show next week, everybody. Yay! And of course, we have another brand new Rugrats in about 15 minutes. But right now, welcome to Lucky Lose, everybody. Yay! Oh, Lucky Lose. But we seem to have a bit of a problem. What I wouldn't do for two burly men to walk into my life in boiler suits.
Would
you look at
them?
Hello, two burly men in boiler suits.
We're still contract plumbers to your service. What's your problem?
I've got a blockage. Can you help me with my blockage? Oh, excellent. Brilliant.
You've got a problem there, look.
I know. Can you help me? Have a glove. Go for it.
What's it cost you, though?
The BBC will pay for it. Go on. Now, just to remind you, we had two competitions last week. The first one was our Snuggle Sacks competition, where we had a set of four Snuggle Sacks to give away, which we can't seem to find our Snuggle Sacks. We can't seem to find our Snuggle Sacks. The question. Now, boys, this is the point where you're supposed to give me the Snuggle Sack. Very good. We did rehearse this. A set of four Snuggle Sacks. Get it out. The question was, come on, you guys, help me. Pull it down. Okay. The question was, when you sleep...
You dream, but what does REM stand for?
Okay, Brian, pick a winner. A set of four Snuggle Sacks. No, don't be picking your nose. Just one. Read it out.
He can't read.
Kirsten Leon, 3, Churton Avenue, Notch Hills, Tynanware. NE29OJS.
Rapid eye movement was the correct answer. And Kirsten Loyn from Tyne and Weir, congratulations to you. A set of Now, our second competition was our Steps competition. We had two sets of tickets to give away to not only go and see Steps in concert, but also meet them afterwards. What a great competition. The question was,
what is the first venue Steps will be playing on the UK tour?
Right. Now, a lot of you wrote in and thought it was Manchester. Now, we did check with Steps management, and unfortunately, it was Sheffield was the correct answer. If you remember, there was two dates. There was Manchester on the 30th of October. Pick a winner. Stick your hand in. Just come on. Be careful. Now, you see... Sheffield Arena is correct.
It's
another Emma. Emma Hornsby from Concert in County Durham. Congratulations, so you're going to see Steps. Our second winner, Brian, get down here. Pick it out. Now gently, boys.
There's this. Kerry Theobald, 20 Guildford Road.
Kerry, you're not supposed to read out the whole address. Canterbury in Kent. Correct answer, Sheffield. Congratulations, you are going to see Steps in concert. You guys are going to be singing later.
No, I like the voices, but right now, Mitch, what's still to come?
What's still to come here on Live and Kicking. And remember, you can't beat the system. Baby Spice, Emma Bunton will be here live and chatting later. You've just seen one episode. We've got two more episodes of The Rogue Babies, The Rugrats on the way. The Honeyz will be buzzing in to join us on this non-stop showbiz Saturday morning. And then the bit of the show when the camera crew will have a piece of toast. It's Smart Guy getting into the groove later. Britney Spears still here, hanging around, and you can speak to her on the phone later. I've just said good morning to this lot. Westlife have arrived, and they'll be performing Flying Without Wings very soon. Also, Diana Ross, only the world's most successful singer ever, will be here, and will play her new video. All coming up after Clunk the Junk.
Clunk the Junk.
Yes, thank you, Mitch. Welcome to Clunk the Junk, everybody. Now, our space pod was looking very bare yesterday, but or last week, but not anymore. Take a look, everybody.
Wow.
I want so much ooing and aahing and wowing. We've got so many fantastic pictures. Thank you so much, everybody. We've got aliens, we've got rocket ships, we've got Malcolm the alien. Mitch, aren't they amazing?
They're fantastic. We've got loads, haven't we?
Malcolm is very happy. There's this gorgeous picture of him. It's sent in by Gemma Johnson. Can you see that?
That's good.
Yes, isn't that good?
Whoa.
And we got loads of them. Now, unfortunately, we can't show them all individually, so we've come up with the Galactic Gallery. Take a look at this.
Yeah, Galactic Gallery. Thanks for sending all these fantastic pictures. Here's five of the best that we thought were good. Here's a good one from Reese Sidley, a very happy alien. Reese lives in Shepparton. Thanks for that. Who's this? This is Cuddles with a great big mouth. Francesca Slucock from Scotland wants to say hello to her friends Helen and Laura. Hello, Helen and Laura. Here's an alien with three eyes in a green spaceship thing. Jodie Day in Watford drew this. And here's another flying saucer, the lonely little alien in it, drawn by Laura Webb in Cottershaw. And here's a very artistic one. This is Tyler Sparks drew this alien, and Tyler lives in Barnet. Thank you, Tyler!
Wow, so talented. Thank you so much for all your fantastic pictures, and please keep sending them in. Now, right now, it is time to play Clunk the Junk, though, so let me just remind you about how it works. Along with Malcolm, our little space alien, you need to move up, down, left and right, and Clunk the Junk. You just scream, grab at absolutely everything that you see, except for the asteroids, because, Mitch, what happens if you get hit by an asteroid?
I think you're out, aren't you?
Well, you're not out, but you lose a point.
Oh, you lose a point.
Yes, up, down, left and right, but don't let the asteroids hit you, or else you lose a point. So that's how to play, and Mitch, what are the prizes?
Well, I only work on this show. I'm not expected
to know how anything
works. No, I'm trying to get to sleep. If you get between 1 and 4 points, you get this selection of books. If you get between 5 and 8 points, we'll send you a fantastic bendy construction set. 9 to 12 points gets you a Spaceman hot water bottle, and 13 to 16 points gets you a Simpsons rucksack doll and a chess set. 17 to 20 points, that's the top prize. We'll give you a CD Walkman and all these CDs, and every prize winner today gets a laughing alien, Emma.
Wow. Brilliant, brilliant prizes. So, let's see who's on the phone. Now, we've got so many calls. We're going to go straight to the phones, and what line should I do? Maybe line 17?
17.
Hello, who's on line 17?
Hi, it's Kim Murphy from Belfast.
Hello, how are you this morning?
Fine, thanks.
From Belfast. I'm going home today. Later on. What are you up to in Belfast?
Nothing much.
No?
No.
Weekend off, no school?
Yeah.
That's always good.
Yeah.
So you're just going to watch Live and Kickin' and hang around and...
Yeah.
Brilliant. Now you know how to play Clunk the Junk?
Yeah.
Understand the rules?
Yeah.
All right, are you ready to play? 3, 2, 1, take it away.
There.
Come on, Tim.
Clunk. Up, up, clunk. Left, left, up, clunk.
Careful of the asteroids.
Left,
oh, well done.
Right, up, up, clunk. Right,
right, get
up, clunk.
Hey. Very good, Tim. Come
doing
on.
Brilliantly.
Get clunking.
Left, clunk.
Congratulations. 9 points, Mitch. What has he won?
Well done, Tim. You can be all cozy in bed now. We're going to send you this Spaceman. I'm sure you love this Spaceman hot water bottle. And, of course, a fantastic laughing alien as well. Well done, Tim.
Congratulations, Tim. Thank you for playing.
Thank you.
Okay, have a nice weekend.
Bye.
Okay. See you, Tim.
Next, we're on... what line should I pick? Line 23.
23.
I'm having loads of fun today. Just pick any line. Line 23. Who's on line 23?
Hello.
Hello, who's this?
Abby.
Hello, Abby. Where are you calling us from?
London.
Right here in London.
London.
What are you up to in London today?
Nothing much.
Well, you're all very boring. You're not doing anything.
No.
With your weekend off.
Yeah.
No? Okay, well, you understand all the rules for Clunk the Junk?
Yeah.
More than
you're
I
ready
do.
To play? Yes, much more than the rest of us too.
Yeah.
Okay, you ready, Abby? 3, 2, 1, go!
Forward. Left.
Come on, Abby.
Clunk, up.
Shout really loudly, Abby.
Up. Left. Clunk.
Clunk.
Grab, grab.
Yay. Left.
One, there you go, left.
Up. Left.
Come on, Abby.
Clunk.
Oh, careful of the asteroids.
Clunk. Clunk.
Good.
Left.
Go on, keep going, left.
Down. Clunk.
Oh. No. 3 points. Well done, Abby. Mitch, what has she won?
Well done, Ali Olibandu. You got 3 points, so this is good. This is good for your intellect. We're going to send you this big selection of books. How about that?
Yeah. Brilliant. That's brilliant, Abby. Listen, thank you for playing. Have a nice weekend.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye. And there will, of course, be more Clunk the Junk next week. They did very well. And please, please keep sending in your pictures. They're absolutely brilliant. To our usual address, Live and Kicking, P.O. Box 8181, London, W12 6. But right now, I think it's time for some music.
Yes.
They were on the show last week. It was Steps. We liked them, didn't we, Mitch?
Yes, we like Steps.
And it's their brand new song, which is called... I just
After
have to check.
The
After the Love Has Gone.
Teamwork.
In the Blue Peter Garden. Didn't realise I was on then. Here we are on the Blue Peter... What on earth? Sorry. Oh, Bobby's Bistro. What's going on? Big guy. What are you doing? What are you doing with all... What are you doing with all the smoke? Yeah? Oh, you're trying to get the bees out of the hive. Trying to get the bees out. And you're trying to make the bees go that way. Why do you want them to go that way? What's up here, Si? Oh, it's the flowers. Morning, flowers. All right. So you want the bees back this way. You want the bees to go to the hive. No, to go to the flowers to make what? Honey?
Honey!
Yeah. Who, why? What, who for? Why?
For
the honeys. I see. Right. Okay. Well, you're not having much luck, really, are they? They're not really coming out. Hang on. Come on.
No,
you get.
No,
come on.
No,
whoa. I think we're going to leave you to it, big guy. I think, go on, off you go. I think we're going to leave him to it. Let's tell you how to play Blobby's Bistro instead, shall we? Now then, who do you think this might be? We've got a dish of a day for you. Who do you think that is just there? Feeling hungry? Fancy some eggs and Beckham? I mean bacon. Who do you think that might be for you? Hey, who do you think that might be? That's the dish of the day. If you get picked to play, you instantly win... The Live and Kicking fleece, just
very
here.
Nice.
There's the logo, nice. Just there. Nice, isn't it? And the Miss It Miss Out. Ooh, there's bees everywhere. Miss It Miss Out wallet as well. Side of the cameraman's got that. There's also other prizes to be won. Now, Mitch.
Yes.
We're going to do this a bit differently now.
Are we?
We're going to go over to our
mind the bees.
Still can't. Si, what's it called? The conveyor belt. That's what it's called. I keep wanting to call it a carousel. We're going to go to the conveyor belt just here.
Okay.
I'm going to wind the prizes along, and you tell us what they are. Okay.
Okay. I'm glad people explain to me what I have to do because I've got no idea. I got stung by a bee the other day. £3.50. For a jar of honey, can you believe that? Ha ha ha. Now let's have a look at the prizes on offer, the conveyor belt today. First up is a beautifully handcrafted blobby known made by the world-renowned artist L. Julian out of the props department. Prize number two is this fantastic watch thing, which is sort of red. And prize number one on offer tonight is this lovely portable television which works on electricity. And you
fantastic.
Can win it.
Is that enough? Nice. Thank you very much.
Enough waffling.
That kind of worked, didn't it?
Yeah,
we just make it. Anyway, they're the prizes to be won. Let's go and recap the dish of the day just over here, shall we? Who do you think this might be? I'll tell you what, he's on the show next week.
Lovely.
That's a clue. Who do you think that might be? If you think you know, give us a call now on this number. Leave your name, your number, and your answer, of course. Lines close at 11:30 this morning, and ask permission before you call as well. I'll tell you what, it's been mayhem out here this morning. Let's go and see what Mr. Blobby's doing, shall we? Hang on. What are you doing? What have you... You've got honey.
Yeah.
No, you've got the honeys. You've got our guests for this morning. Now listen to me. You cannot keep three beautiful girls out in the Blue Peter Garden trapped just for yourself all day. Surely you don't need all three. Can't I have one?
Oh,
go on. Please?
Yeah,
fantastic. Thank you very much, Mr. B. Let's have a look at our second Rugrats and a whole new stew.
Hello.
I do love that Dylan. He's just the cutest.
Isn't he?
Don't you think?
Love him.
Yeah.
Much more Rugrats Gold coming up later on. Much more.
Oh, yes.
Much more. There will be Rugrats Gold coming up later on. Now, we did do letters earlier on, didn't we? So we're not mad, but we did get a very special letter in that I thought might be a bit appropriate to read now. It reads, Dear Steve and Emma, please, 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 can you read this letter out when Westlife come on the show? I went to Party in the Park in Cardiff and I thought it was great. I think that Westlife were the best group there and I went mad when they came on. I was near the front but I couldn't get very good photos. I've put in one that I took where you can see, where you can just make out Nikki, Shane and Brian. Now,
let's have a look at
can
that.
Can you see that? It's really not
Is
very
it?
Clear.
It's a bit, you can kind of see
kind
that.
Of, sorry, my fingers are in there. They're kind of in the background there.
Yeah.
And it says, I would be really, really grateful if you could send me a better photo than the one I have.
Well, I'll tell you what, we can do something better than that, actually. Let's call Westlife in. Westlife, in you come. Come on, boys.
Oh, the men.
Here they come.
The men are in the house.
How are you doing?
I feel right.
Good to see you.
Good to see you. Now, what was her name? What was the name of
your... Can I sit in the... No.
Is it... No, you can't sit in the middle of all the men. Is it Keisha?
Keisha Barker. Keisha. And she comes from Thornhill and Gwent.
Right. Okay, now, Keisha has done this photograph. And admittedly, she says it's not very good, yeah, this photo. So I thought, to make it a bit better, if I hand that to you, Shane, can you all sign her photo for her?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Sure, of course.
Because isn't that the best way to make a not very good photo an incredible one, by getting the band to actually sign it, do you think? That's very nice, isn't it?
And we can probably maybe get a better one.
Shane didn't have to say Keisha. Look,
he put a K.
Can you all say hello to Keisha as well? Just say a big
hello.
Hey, fantastic. Excellent. We've got a cool show coming up later.
Oh, brilliant show. But right now, it's time to see what not so smart things our smart guy is getting up to.
www.cutekid.com. I skipped 6 whole grades. You really expect me to fall for that?
But can you do this? Huh? Can you do that, genius?
I'm not saying yes, and I'm not saying no.
Wise up to Smart Guy later.
It really is quite funny.
Oh, yes. I'm just trying to debate something here. You'll see all in a minute. Time now for a great Live and Kicking giveaway.
Hey!
Yes, now then, take a look at this. This little fella.
Oh, yeah.
Well, not them. That one. Thanks, Dave.
Right.
That is a Furby. Now, these took the world by storm last Christmas, the hottest selling toy. Now, they've been very busy over the last year, these Furbies. They don't stop talking either. They've been very busy over the past year because there's now the pattering of tiny feet because they've had little babies. Oh yes, little babies, and they are now the hottest thing on the shelves, and they're not even available anywhere at the moment. This is a Live and Kicking exclusive. If you want to win some Furby babies, you need to answer this question. What type of baby animal is a Joey? What type of baby animal is a Joey? If you think you know, send your answers to this address. It's Live and Kicking, PO Box 8181, London, W12, 6. Oh yes, what are you doing?
Oh, excuse me. Hello there, Stevie boy.
All right.
Haven't got any more of those Furbies, have you? We've got 2 pieces of bread left and there's nothing to go in them.
You're not supposed... They're prizes, they're not food.
I'll best see to the boil in the bag one. Sorry. Oh, dear.
Give me strength. No, in fact, give me Britney Spears. Go on, please. Go on.
Okay, now Britney may have trouble with her geometry and Spanish schoolwork, but she has all the angles, for a top pop career, and she's very popular in Spain. She's had 2 number one hits there already, and at 17, Britney is pretty much near the top of the class in showbiz land. Britney's been performing since junior school, and her first job was actually presenting the Mickey Mouse Club after winning this talent contest at the tender age of 10.
Britney Spears.
Oh, and a 30, keep believing.
There at 16, she scored an A+, really, as her first single went straight to number one, and it went to number one all over the world. I reckon her school uniform days are now behind her, and with a hit US tour under her belt, a top 10 album, and a second hit single to add to her CV, she's currently riding high with her third single, Crazy. Oh, she's a pretty crazy babe. Let's say good morning now to Britney Spears.
Britney Spears, first ever live time in Live and Kicking. Welcome to the show again. We kind of done that onward. And we've had so many calls, it's not even funny for you. So I'm going to go straight to the phones.
Okay.
To line one. Hello, who's on line one?
Hello, this is Jasmine Hayward.
Hello, Jasmine. What's your question for Britney?
Who drives you crazy and why?
Who drives you crazy and why?
Who drives me crazy?
Honestly, who drives you crazy?
Probably Brad Pitt, because I think he's a hottie. And because he's too old for me, it drives me crazy that I can't, have him.
Have you ever met him?
No.
Oh, but you'd like to meet him.
Oh, I would die.
Okay. Studio question. Thank you, Jasmine. Studio question. Amy. Amy, where are you? Oh, what's your question?
What audience is your song targeted for?
I think it's for all audiences. I think it's good for young kids and then teenagers as well, because I know I'm a teenager and I like to listen to my music sometimes. And well, not all the time because I have to perform it all the time, but I think if I wasn't Britney Spears, I would want to listen to it. So I think all ages.
Brilliant. Now, our third question was a web question. We've got loads of questions on the web and on the website. So this comes from Ella, and it says, if you were stranded on a desert island, what three things would you take and why? Brad Pitt, no. What three things would you take and why?
I would bring my CDs, mm-hmm. so I could listen
who,
to
Who do you listen to?
I listen to...
Who do you like?
I like Lauryn Hill. Mm. I like Missy Elliott. I like Natalie Imbruglia. I like a variety of people. I love the Backstreet Boys.
Cool.
I'd definitely bring my CDs, lots of food and ice cream.
Yes.
And Brad Pitt.
And Brad Pitt. Okay, back to the phones. Line five. Who's on line five?
Stacey.
Hello, Stacey. What's your question for Britney?
Which music or artist do you admire, and did that make an impact on the music you produce?
I really like Madonna. I love her music, and I like her as a performer as well, because when she's on stage, you never know what she's gonna do. You know, you're always in awe of her. And I like Whitney Houston vocally, because I think she sings from her heart and her soul, definitely. And their music has definitely been a major impact on my music, I think, because I express myself a lot in my music. And I think because I am so young, my music will definitely grow as I get older, and it'll be more of an influence on my music as I get older.
Brilliant. We've got a studio question. Dimitri.
What's it like being so famous at such a young age?
17 is very young.
It's fun. It's a lot of fun because I'm always traveling, and I'm always on the road, and I'm always getting to meet so many different really cool people, very talented people, and I love that. I have a wonderful time, you know, definitely.
What's the worst thing?
Is there
a really bad thing? Because it has to be, you know.
Yeah, I guess just being away from my family, yeah. And not being able to see them every single day.
That's but you're going home today.
Yeah, going home today. Good to see them. So.
Okay, back to the phones. Line three. Who's on line three?
Hi, it's Claire.
Hello, Claire. What's your question for Britney?
Is it true that you're going out with Justin from NSYNC?
You're in trouble now.
No, it's not true.
It's not true. Do you have a boyfriend? Can we ask that question? Do you have a boyfriend?
No, I don't have a boyfriend. I'm seeing someone right now. It's not really serious. It's just someone that, you know, when I have time, when we see each other, we go out, we have a lot of fun with each other. But no, it's not Justin. Right.
But Brad Pitt, if you're right there, call.
Yeah.
Okay, Sarah in the studio.
If someone was to make a film of your life, who would you like to play you?
Oh, that's a really good question.
I think Katie Holmes, because I love her as an actress. I think she's amazing. And I think a lot of time people say that we kind of look alike, so probably Katie Holmes.
And Pacey. We like Pacey from Dawson's Creek, don't we?
He's a hottie.
Pacey and Brad Pitt. Okay, back to the phone. Sorry, I do go on, don't I? Line four. Oh, line two. Who's on line two?
Hello.
Who's this?
How do you feel being compared to Christina Aguilera?
Well, it's fine because I knew once I was accepted as being a young female teen pop artist that there were going to be a lot more of me just like right after the Backstreet Boys, and it's fine. I mean, people are going to have their opinions about things, and I think she's wonderful. I think she's amazing. Yeah. Actually, we were on the Mickey Mouse Club with each other, and we keep on running into each other doing promotional stuff. Yeah.
So, I mean, that's brilliant. But there's always competition.
Yeah,
it's healthy. Right, Joanne in the studio. Last question.
Who would you like to swap life with for the day?
For the day? Oh my goodness. Probably Marilyn Monroe, because I think, I don't know, you know, a lot of people talk about her and her life and everything, and she's just really cool, so probably her.
Marilyn Monroe. Brilliant. I'm afraid we have no more time for questions or calls, but we do have an exclusive Britney Spears competition, and we said a little bit about this earlier on. Tell me about these. These are Britney Spears dolls. There's six altogether.
Yes, these are the ones from the video. This is from the Baby One More Time video.
Okay.
This is from Sometimes, and this is from Crazy.
Oh. And they're all signed.
Yes.
All signed by you. Thank you very much.
And then later on, there are going to be some from the tour and my outfits that I wore on the tour, like the opening outfit and some of the other outfits. So.
Cool. Now, these are not available in Europe or in the UK. They just went on sale in America yesterday, so we've got three to give away. Now, the question is, do you know what the question is? We'll do it. The question is, how long was Baby One More Time at number one in the UK charts?
Yes, how long?
Baby One More Time at number one in the UK charts. And just send it to our usual address, Live and Kicking, PO Box 8181, London W12 6LA. Now, I believe one of the special... You're going to be here for our Millennium Show. Not here, but you're going to be performing for our Millennium Show, which is not brilliant, everybody. Britney Spears. Yay! Thank you so much for being on the show. It's a pleasure having you here.
Thank you
and taking all our calls, and we really enjoyed it. Britney Spears, everybody!
Hello, everyone!
And welcome to Science Club, a vague attempt by the BBC to stem accusations of dubbing down. Uh-huh. Well, you make it what it is, you know.
I fetched you a cup of tea.
Oh, thank you very much, Brother Mike.
Shall I pop it down next to this beaker of hydrochloric acid?
Thank you. This week, we're looking at chain reactions. Now then, filling a balloon with air causes a number of chain reactions. Firstly, the molecules of the balloon's skin are forced to move further apart, creating tension. As the balloon increases in size, so does the tension. And if I'm to produce a lady's hatpin,
oh, no.
The tension becomes almost unbearable. A second chain reaction. The force of the blast of the balloon has knocked my brother off his feet. And a third chain reaction. My brother gets up and smacks me in the face. That's smart. Finally, a simple experiment to show how electrostatically charged particles can cause a chain reaction. The charged particles collect in the ball, but they transfer instantaneously to the body of the person who makes contact with the ball, making their hair stand on end.
That's me, isn't it?
It certainly would be, brother of mine, as you have the most hair.
I've got a... Yes, I have, yes. Or, okay. Oh, dear. We'll have to stop.
Last.
Never mind. At least you get a chance to have your tea.
That's very true.
Yes.
Found the biggest Westlife fan in the world. She loved them long before they were called Westlife, when they were called Westside, and even before Nikki and Brian joined the band. She's a big, big fan. Let's take a look at Westlife's number one fan.
There it is. I never want to say goodbye, cause I never want to see you cry. Treat you bad, cause I never want to see you sad. I swore to you my love would remain, and I swear it all over again. Oh.
I tell you what, the voice of an angel, I think there. Voice of an angel. Stephanie, welcome to Live and Kicking.
Thank
How are you?
I'm okay, thanks.
Are you a little bit nervous?
A little bit.
Yeah, you said to me that you were. Now, what is it about Westlife? Just can you explain, what is that one thing that they've got?
They're just such nice, down-to-earth guys, yep. And they've got brilliant voices.
There you go. That sums it up, I think. Right, well, Stephanie, we're going to pit you against every member of Westlife to see who knows most about the band Westlife. First of all, can we please test your honkers? Brian? You wouldn't believe how loud that is standing next to it. Stephanie? There you go. You got the horn just there. Okay. All right, then, we're going to play the game, and you're against the clock, okay? So here is the first question. Good luck to both teams. Here we go. Question one. What is the name of both of Westlife's managers? That was Westlife. Stephanie?
Steve Walsh and
Brendan Keating. Is the right answer! Shane's up next. Okay, how many number one singles have Westlife had?
Two.
Here's the right answer. Sorry, Shane. Off you go. Question three, and it's Mark. Here we go. Who owns a toy cat?
What was the question?
Sorry. Who owns a toy cat called Kitty?
Shane.
It is Shane. Excellent. Question four. Okay, it's Kian. Here we go. Which American band did Westlife first support in Dublin?
That was the band. The
and
band
Zeke?
Got that one.
No, it was. No one knows the answer. No, it was the Backstreet Boys. It was the Backstreet Boys. Okay, next question. Okay, Nikki. Oh, here we go. Second question happens to be about you. Nikki used to be an apprentice footballer for which football team? I think that was you. Go on.
Manchester United.
Nikki, no, it wasn't. What was the answer? Leeds United. That's the right answer. Question six. Who can sing the line which comes after? Hey, leave it out. Who can sing the line which comes after? You find it in the deep...
Band.
Go on.
Oh, yes, you don't know.
Come on.
The kind you cherish all your life.
Yes. 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 Well done, Brian. Okay, next question. Who was born on July the 5th,
19...
Shane.
Yes! I'm sorry, mate.
Well, it was me anyway.
Okay, okay. Which magazine did Brian used to buy every copy? Which one?
Dandy.
No. Which magazine did he... No, it was Discovery. Discovery. There you go. Sorry. Kian, who has a phobia about being stuck in a...
Nikki.
It is Nikki. Okay, well done. Nikki, here we go, here we go. Whose life was saved by a washing line?
Brian's?
No, it was Kian. It was Kian. There we go. That's the end of fans versus bands.
Final
Nick,
score.
What's the score?
Well, the Westlife lot were rubbish. They only got two, but Stephanie got six. Yeah.
Fantastic. There you go. Wait. I've forgotten. There's one more question that I should have done. Hang on. Sorry, one more question that I should have done. Ready? Here we go. Here we go. Who is having a birthday party tomorrow?
Nikki.
It is Nikki. And I believe we've got something for Nikki somewhere. Is it anywhere in the studio? We've got a surprise for Nikki somewhere. Fantastic. Oh, it's over there. Is it? I'm being told to... there we go. Bring it in. It's a birthday cake for Nikki.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday.
Birthday, mate.
We'll be right back with a smart guy right after this important message. This Friday, Linford's Record Breakers is in search of the smallest, the tallest, the loudest, the funniest, the fastest, and the fittest record breakers in the world.
This year is bigger than ever.
Fascinating facts and truly amazing challengers who push themselves to the limit using all their skill, strength, and determination to be the best.
Really go for it!
Linford's Record Breakers, every Friday at 4:35 on CBBC One. He's a smart...
I tell you what, that TJ is a good keyboard player, don't you think? He's brilliant. Anyway, in honour of him, let's tell you what's coming up on the show, shall we? Here we go. Still to come on the show, we are packed with action. Oh yeah! The Honeyz are here.
Yeah.
What an attraction.
Yeah, let's sing it.
And woo. Diana Ross is causing a chain reaction. Fantastic. There's Electric Circus.
Electric Circus. And there's Hit, Miss, or Maybe.
Yeah.
Well, I'm doing Electric Circus.
Oh, yeah, what's on?
Yeah, we've got Christina Aguilera. We've got an exclusive peek at Toy Story 2.
Sounds good.
And Grant says goodbye on EastEnders.
Fantastic.
Anyway,
very exciting.
Oh, yes.
Anyway, Emma Bunton is here, and she's a lovely lady.
Yes, she is.
Oh, yeah. She's taking your calls, and she also sings.
But right now, here's Westlife with Flying Without Wings.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Everybody's looking for that something. One thing that makes it all complete. You find it in the strangest places. Places you never knew it could be. Some find it in the face of their children. Some find it in the lover's eyes. Who can deny the joy it brings when you found that special thing? You're flying without wings. Some find you cheering every morning. Some in the solitary night. You find it in the words of others. Make you laugh or cry. You'll find it in the deepest friendship, the kind you cherish all your life. And when you know how much that means, you found that special.
something. You're flying without wing. So impossible. Cause they may see you got to fight.
Shane's going to be on Hit Miss or Maybe a little bit later with the one and only Baby Spice. Emma Bunton's going to be there as well. And the Honeyz. Very nice indeed. Actually, you know what? Talking to the Honeyz, I'm a bit worried. Mr. Blobby, you know, the bees connection with Honeyz. He's been causing a bit of mayhem with them this morning. We better go over to the breakfast area, check out what's going on. Hello, girls.
Hi.
How you doing? You all right? Where's no sign of the big pink guy, Mr. Blobby?
But he gave us some honey, so can I... Blobby's honey now.
Blobby's honey. Yeah. How did he make that? He couldn't make any honey. How did he manage that? Oh, well, never mind.
Oh, lovely.
Anyway, it does look quite nice, actually. Anyway, enough of that. Let's tell you how to play Blobby's Bistro. Dish of the day, please. The side, there we go. Dish of the day. Who do you think this is just there? Who is that? Who that is? Eggs and bacon, even. Who do you think that might be? If you think you know, and you get picked to play randomly by a computer, here's what you win. It's the Miss It, Miss Out wallet. Very nice. Hey, get out of it. Also, the live and kicking fleece as well. There it is. Just there. Very nice. That's what you win. And there's also a star prize. Mitch, what is it?
Ah, yes, it's this full of newfangled electricity stuff. It's a television. Oh, yes!
Oh, thank you. Hello. I was just saying, it's okay. I didn't mind them doing that then with my ear.
That's
I
like okay.
it, in fact. Anyway, so that's the star prize. Let's recap the dish of the day again, shall we? Where is it? There it is. Who do you think that might be? Who do you think? If you think you know, give us a call on this number now.
Play Blobby's Bistro on 0900 on 11444 11444.
Anyway, that's the number to give us a call on. Honey's quite nice. Where is Mr. Blobby? Ah, there you are. A big guy. How did you manage to make honey? How did you manage to make
honey? I did it!
You dressed like a bee?
Yeah!
You made friends with them?
Yeah!
All right, if you're that good friends. Where are your new mates now, then?
Oh, baby, I love the
shadows disappear, I'll be waiting.
That since the Honeyz came to this part of the studio, we've got men gathering up here. Yay! We've got all the cameramen all here. Welcome to the show, you guys.
You.
Now, tell me, how was your summer?
Summer.
Good summer.
It's mad. We're everywhere. We're all over Asia, Japan.
It's really, really big over there.
We didn't stop. I mean, Australia was brilliant because, I mean, obviously we were very successful there. We had double platinum and toured Japan, everywhere in Japan. That was mad.
How was Japan? Did you like Japan?
It's lovely. Yeah, it's really good. It's very different. I mean, they get excited about anything. You know, they see in the stream, they know you grew. It's funny.
That's great.
We ate our favourite food, Japanese food.
Oh, no, I'm not a Japanese fan, but... Now, your new single, we just saw it, Never Let You Down. Tell me a little bit about that. What's it about?
Never Let You Down is quite self-explanatory, really. It's just basically about never letting somebody down. But we are dedicating this song to our fans for not letting us down when Heavenly left the group and for still supporting us up to this day. So it's really a dedication to them.
And speaking of Heavenly Leaving, this is the first song that your vocals are featured on.
Yeah.
So how is that for you? Is that a big step? I mean, you're in the group ages, so it's wrong to say, oh, you know, you're new.
No, people keep saying, oh, how
you're
new.
And I was like, I've been great. Yeah, no, you have been there for ages, but it must have been a bit of a step to kind of, you know, feature your vocals. How is that?
Well, this song's going to be a sort of sentimental to me because it was one of the first songs I actually got in the studio to record with the girls. So it's a bit nerve-wracking as well because, you know, it's out this week and I was like, oh, how's it going to do now? I'm in it, you know. But, everybody's been so supportive of me being here. I'm so happy.
Our fans are lovely.
Yeah.
We have really good friends. We're very lucky.
Big wave for all the fans. Big wave for all the fans. Now, over the summer, you've done a couple of duets. You did one with Another Level.
Mm-hmm.
You, at the Mobo Awards, you duetted, well, sang with Kelly Rock. Did you enjoy that?
Oh, that was so much fun.
I mean, is that something you'd like to do again?
Oh, definitely. That song's going to be our next single.
With the Kelly LaRocque one?
Yeah, but it won't be with Kelly LaRocque.
Oh, okay. Okay. So it was fun because no one has ever seen us dance, actually, and really, you know, because usually everyone thinks we just stand there, oh, the Honeyz.
We shocked a few people, I think.
Yeah, definitely.
Well, that's never a bad thing, shocking
a
few people.
It's a good
thing. I think you've shocked everybody here today. What's your name? Dave's just there growing your hair. Well, listen, thank you so much, guys, for being here. Big wave from the boys upstairs. And right now it's time to find out how David is getting on in Chester. Steve, take it away. We've got your number.
Sorry, I was just thinking about the Honeyz just then. Anyway, let's recap. We've got your number. Now, earlier, the LNK camera crew and our man in situation, Otis, surprised David Mogg, as Emma just said, from Chester. Take a look at this. We surprised David when he was out shopping with his family, and David's a woodwork fanatic, and we called him out when he was thinking that he was doing an in-store promotional video, when in fact he was live on BBC One. And also Dave's hero is Handy Andy, and guess what? Oh yes, we arranged that too here on We've Got Your Number. So let's find out. Otis, how you getting on, mate? How you doing?
Everything is going really well here. As you can see, right, we got some bits of wood down here, okay? We got some, like, metal turny things and, like, sawy things as well. So it's all great, as you can see. But before we go on, I just want to introduce you to the whole DIY team here. As you know, we've got Handy Andy. Very lovely day. We've got me, Odd Job Otis, now rechristened OJ. Thanks, mate. And, of course, down here, we've got the star of this morning, DIY Dave. All right, up in the place. So, and also for Ant-Man, because she was the one that got him into all this mess in the first place, we've got Charlie, Dave's older sister. And Charlie, I'd like you to make some drawers to help us out, okay? So if you'd just like to step back with some bits of wood and some screws down there, so you do your thing. Now, what is it we're doing right now?
What are
we making?
Well, Dave, as you know, mate, Otis has been a total pest, hasn't he, this morning? He's done nothing. We've been working very hard, but Otis has been doing nothing. As you can see how clean he is and how dirty we are, yes?
Right. Okay. Do you think we're going to get everything done in half an hour? That's all we've got, like 30 minutes.
Maybe.
Yeah? You reckon? You think if we put our minds to it, we can really achieve, you know, our goal? Excellent. That's really cool. Do you like this? What do you think of this, Steve?
It's not bad, mate.
Yeah? You like it?
It's not bad. I'm just wondering, it's not actually that good, really, is it? Did you make that?
Yeah, it's just a little something I threw together last night.
Really?
It's Angelica from Rugrats.
Yeah, I can see that. Well, don't give up your day job, mate.
Ooh,
oh, I'm sorry. Did I tell you what? Seeing as you're in the mood, why don't you link to Rugrats Gold for me?
Excellent! Cool! Oh, but I can't do it without, you know, the black and white flavour.
All right, let's make it go black and white.
Get nostalgic.
All right, here we go. There you go. All right, there you are.
Black and white now, yeah?
Yep.
Okay, so now, ladies and gentlemen, for your viewing pleasure and entertainment, here is Angelica of Rugrats in Psycho Angelica. It's Rugrats Gold.
Okay, more Rugrats coming up next week. It's Saturday morning, it's 11:20 now. Have a look at this. Diana Ross has inspired the generations. It all began in the 60s when she was topping the charts alongside the Beatles when she was lead singer of the Supremes. In the 70s, Diana went solo and had huge success in the days of our Steve's favourite band, ELO. Nice choice, Steve. Didn't stop there. Diana continued to have number one hits throughout the 80s, alongside the early days of Madonna and those young guns, Wham! And she still had time to launch a film career and do lots of work for charity. Looks a bit like our BBC dressing room. Now, her success has gone from strength to strength. And in the 90s, her talents range from businesswoman, mother of five children, Oscar-nominated film star, and record breaker as, listen to this, the most successful female vocalist of all time. Now, the legendary diva herself has flown in. Let's give it up this morning for Diana Ross.
Fantastic. She actually said she really enjoyed watching that just then,
yes,
didn't you?
Yes, thank you for that. That was really a nice reminder.
You're looking very welcome, Diana.
Looking back, what would be your favourite time, perhaps, from all of those eras then that you were...
Oh, gosh. Maybe the Supreme time.
Yeah?
With the Supremes, yes.
Brilliant. Yeah. Absolutely brilliant. Now, this is a show, obviously, for younger people. You have some children yourself.
I have five children.
Yeah. Name them. What are their names?
Rhonda, Tracy, Chutney, Ross and Evan.
Excellent. Now, what kind of music, I mean, with the musical mother, what kind of music do they listen to? What's their kind of musical taste?
Well, all different. Really? My oldest daughter likes jazz. My second daughter, Tracy, likes music from my era, you know, like Bill Withers and people like that. And then Chutney, I think, like Sade and all of that, and very current music. But the boys like Michael Jackson.
Yes.
And
excellent. Yes. Oh, that's good. Are any of them musically talented? Singers or
Well, I
musicians
think they
or?
Will probably be in show business. They're very creative and they like music a lot and dancing.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Excellent. Now, you have a single out. You also have a new album, don't you, called Every Day.
Every Day is a New Day.
It's a new day. So is that a philosophy of yours? Do you treat every day as a new day?
I would like to do that. I'd like to stay in the moment if I could, you know, like be here now. Uh-huh. No, I try not to live too far in the future or too far in the past.
No, that's good. Just live for the moment.
Every day is a new day.
That's a pretty fair judgment, don't you think? Live for the moment, I think. Absolutely. Now, I've heard you love to dance.
I do.
You do. Now, what kind of dancing do you do? What?
Very modern dancing, like kids dance. I like dancing, and I like watching dancers.
Really?
Yes, very much.
Do you do any of the kind of, you know, the big craze of the Latino at the moment, the kind of, you know, the salsa dancing and all that kind of thing? Do you do
no,
any of that?
No, I do just the modern, whatever's happening, you know.
Really?
I just move.
Can you just show me a movement?
No.
I'm the most hopeless dancer in the world. Is it all in the shoulders?
No, you know what? It's funny because in the 60s when I started off, they did dances like the twist and the jerk or the swim. And then the next time, it was all about just moving the body, a lot of hip movement, you know, but I think it's all in the shoulders and everything now, or in the, it's a lot of drama in the attitude, you know, how you do it.
Yeah. Well, we can tell from your new video, she's a brilliant mover, don't you think? She's also, and a fantastic...
I'm mostly a poser. I let the dancers do the dancing and I kind of just pose, you know?
Stand there and look gorgeous, as you do. Let's have a look at a new video, shall we? Let's have a look at your latest single. Yeah!
My every dream, I am yours.
sound a little more bass.
Kisses, the way you made me blush. Life is cruel, now that you're gone. I love you so I can't let go. I'm crazy for you.
One very cool lady, there's the brand new single from Diana Ross, and that's called Not Over You Yet.
Wasn't that brilliant? I see what you mean when you say that the dancers are doing the dancing and you're just standing there looking really good. And you do look really, really good. Well, look, before you go, Diana, it's been such a pleasure having you here. Before you go, we thought we'd take you back to when your music business just started out, when you were with the Supremes. Here's our guests, the Honeyz, with a Supreme tribute of their own, just for you.
One, two, three. Baby love, my baby love, I need ya, oh how I need ya. When all you do is treat me bad, break my heart and leave me sad. Tell me what did I do wrong to make you stay away so long. Baby love, my baby love, I miss ya, miss kissing ya. Instead of breaking
don't
up,
throw our love
just
away.
Just a kiss and making
don't
up.
Throw our love
don't
away.
Throw our love away.
Baby, baby, baby.
Yeah! Thank you. Thank you very much to the Honeyz. Thanks to Diana Ross, everyone. Thank you for coming in. Here's everyone in Electric Circus now. Thanks for coming in.
Wonderful. Hi and welcome to Electric Circus, your essential guide to the latest news and reviews from the world of showbiz. Stealing the limelight this week, we take an exclusive peek at Woody and Buzz's latest adventure. I'll be pulling the plug on Grant's big splash and hold tight for a swinging time at the Tarzan premiere. But first, the news. Christina Aguilera's debut single, Genie in a Bottle, went straight to number one, making her a very hot property. With our fingers firmly on the pop pulse, we decided to find out the secret formula behind the song's success.
Well, right now, you know, it fits in well with what's going on in music today. It's very pop, but it's edgier than a lot of pop because it does have a very R&B, soulful influence to it. I'm a genie in a bottle, baby. Say so, it's a few melody hooks and ideas. I have like a little hooky thing in Genie, but the rest of the verses and things I didn't get to write, unfortunately. I'm a genie in a bottle, baby. Come, come, come on and be a... You know, it's one thing to be number one in the US, and you know, that's amazing within itself, but to know that you're having an impact in the rest of the world and all these other countries, it's just fabulous.
It's official, the toys are back in town as Buzz and Woody return for another adventure in Toy Story 2. Not released until February 2000, here's an exclusive preview of what's in store.
He's stealing Woody.
Woody, do something!
Woody was kidnapped.
We will not rest until he's safe in Andy's room.
I'm packing you your angry eyes, just in case.
Geronimo!
Don't talk to any toy you don't know!
What are we gonna do, Buzz?
Use your head.
But I don't want to use my head!
I'm tour guide Bobby.
I'm a marriage butter.
Don't let go of the wall.
Why? He wouldn't.
He would.
I'm like the wind, bullseye.
And if you want to see the American trailer in full, just log on to our website, www.bbc.co.uk/kicking. Now on Thursday, 15 million of you EastEnders fans tune in to watch Grant Mitchell make a dramatic exit from the show with an amazing high-speed car chase. And if you're wondering how they filmed that seat of your pants stunt, wonder no more. So did the actors really do their own stunts?
They do some of the driving, but when it comes to something which is more dangerous and hazardous, you can't afford to let the artists do too much.
For safety, the car was actually driven by Phil and Grant's stunt doubles.
I'm Nick Wilkinson, stunt artist, and I'm doubling Grant. Today I'm
Well, for this particular episode, I'm doubling Phil Mitchell.
Action.
They filmed it in such a way that if they knew it was me, the game's up.
For the crash into the Thames, dummies of the Mitchell brothers were placed inside the car. The vehicle was then fired into the water from a steep ramp to ensure that it flew through the air at high speed. By the use of sneaky camera angles and clever editing, the director had us all fooled. We will miss you, Grant. Now, if you are lucky enough to already own a Dreamcast, then here's a wintry game to warm your heart. Out now, Pen Pen features Sparky and his gaggle of mates as they take you on a ride through their Arctic playground. With icy obstacles to belly slide, run and swim around, this game has some of the wackiest 3D animation around. Simple to control and full of zany characters, the game's a surefire hit for all the family. What's more, players are rewarded with funky costumes to protect their characters from the Arctic chill. With its fluid action and fashionable accessories, Pen Pen is great for the young, style-conscious game player. But if you like rapid-fire action, this one might leave you out in the cold. Earlier this week, stars swung into London's West End for the premiere of Tarzan. We sent our cameras along to ask them what they thought of the Lord of the Jungle's latest movie. Like elephants at a watering hole, the crowds gathered around the Odeon Leicester Square to take in the sights of celebs in their natural habitat, a showbiz premiere. Rising to the Tarzan fashion challenge was today's guest, Emma Bunton.
A modern-day Jane. Oh, yeah, I'd love to. Like, I'm dressed for the part, do you think? No? Tried.
But how many of the guests would actually survive as well as Tarzan?
I'd probably get by, but I don't know how I'd get on with four children to look after as well. That might be a bit hard work.
Appallingly. I like my luxuries. I'm embarrassed to say, but I really do.
Can you imagine me being about 3 miles away from a hairdryer? You know?
I think I'd be dreadful, actually. At the first sign of a mosquito, I run a mile.
I'm very keen to see what Walt Disney had done with it.
You just expect such a high standard, not only of animation, but also of the story and the humour as well.
Turk, I'm asking you as a friend.
All right! But don't make me do anything embarrassing.
There's a lot of things that have never been put into the live-action films. Like the fact that Tarzan can talk to the animals is something that you never really see in the live-action films and something that makes it perfect for us.
Oddly enough, it was Tarzan's author, Edgar Rice Burroughs, who was the first to think of telling the story through animation over 80 years ago.
Being a Tarzan fan, this is the closest, in actual fact, to the novels. I mean, they've changed it a little bit. They've made it a little bit more politically correct for the modern day. We better go. Phil Collins' company is far more important.
I think with the animation with Disney, they get the beats of the story with the songs, and then they weave the story around the songs. There's all those songs that are definitely joined at the waist with the movie, but the movie in the end is the most important thing.
I thought personally that this was definitely one of Disney's best films, but just a word of advice, if you're anything like me, bring a box of tissues. And you can see Tarzan swing into action at a cinema near you next Friday. Now don't forget to make a date in your diary next week for an Irish double bill, honestly no bias here, by which you'll be casting a spell on the show, and Nicky from Westlife will be back as he takes us on a trip into cyberspace. So if you miss it, you will definitely miss out.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
She talking like that for you sound like a great big girl's blouse. It sound like Mitch, actually.
Oi, I'm listening to that.
He's always there, isn't he?
He is, isn't he?
I'm omnipresent.
You are omnipresent. Mitch. 50 pence. Look at this, Mitch. He's got 50 pence.
50p.
Don't tell me. You've not been asking for money off the audience again, have you?
Is the audience in? No, just... No, listen. You know when we're not on?
Yes, when we're off, you mean?
When we're not on, we're off.
We're off. We're frequently off, actually.
It's up, yes, up and down, isn't
we
it?
Yeah, it is up and down.
But we're happy.
Yes, happy little
chap. I've got myself a little sideline.
A sideline?
A little earner.
A little earner, a little Saturday job.
What I do, you see, I go along to the dressing rooms, knock on the door, I fetch the people and I bring them to the studio floor.
You're a fetcher?
Fetcher? That's what I do.
It's a responsibility.
That's why I'm wearing the armband.
You're not wearing an armband.
Strange, that. It's bigger than my arm. Jeez. Never mind. No, this isn't. Anyway, look.
Where'd you get that from?
Mr. Blobby.
Oh, right. Yeah. Yes. I'm your brother.
What?
Your brother. I'm your brother.
Oh, all right. Have it.
Thank you very much.
There you are,
50p.
I've got this.
What you got? A fiver? Where'd you get that from?
I got this.
Liz from Westlife.
Oh,
down
Westlife.
The corridor, knock on the door, bring him to the studio floor.
Yes.
Courteous and kind.
Courteous and kind.
Firm, but delightful.
It's a fantastic job. I want to have a go at this job. Where'd you get the names from?
Board.
Well, they're probably switching off all over the country right now, but...
The board!
Oh, there's a board!
Yes!
Wow, very organised. Yes. Blobby?
Done that.
Westlife?
Done that.
Fetch Britney's ears.
What? No, just... No! Oh, goodness! Did you give you something?
Yes, a black eye.
Oh, dear. Limp this way.
I don't know what went wrong.
No, someone took the pee.
We've got your number.
I only just got that gag then from the leprechauns. Anyway, let's tell you what happened. We've got your number earlier. Now, earlier this morning, Otis and our hit squad went to surprise David Mogg, who's from Chester. Have a look at this. Here's what happened this morning.
Good morning, David. You know, we know all about you and your obsession with woodwork and with DIY. And I'll tell you why, because... Your sister, haven't you?
Hey, that's what happened when I surprised him and phoned up on his dad's mobile. Now we're going to find out how. I've got the names here. Odd Job Otis, DIY Dave and Handy Andy have gone on creating their masterpiece. Otis, have you finished?
We have very nearly finished. As you can see, have a look behind us here. This is DIY Dave's handiwork with a tiny bit of help from Handy Andy. It's a tool cupboard. You see, we didn't tell you earlier because we actually wanted you to
surprise.
Try and guess what it was.
Surprise.
But of course, you'll need to know how our progress went as we were working on this very hard this morning. And I've made a tape here, so let me just press pause and it should roll. Okay, as you can see, we're all together there now, starting looking at a bit of paper. And I'm working very hard. You can see I'm actually doing my thing. I've got a drill in my hand there, painting, and Dave's doing his thing in the background there, so he's got a giant bit of wood in his hand. He's doing a bit of, you know, putting the things in there, and he's opening and closing a drawer there, and there's me again, and then ta-da! You see, the finished project. What else can I say? Absolutely marvellous. So, tell us exactly, Andy, how we've adapted.
Dave, you've been fantastic, by the way. This guy has been really good. First of all, obviously, we painted some really jazzy colours. Mm-hmm. The flat pack, we've assembled it really nice, painted it lovely, cut out a saw on the top there. Cut out some spanners for handles, yeah?
This is Charlie's drawer, incidentally, the one that Dave's older sister made for him. He did not buy it, it's all right.
But Dave, cut this out. A bit of MDF cutting there, mate. Well,
MDF.
On the side here, we cut a screwdriver out, put some bits on some clamps. On the other side there, there's a hammer. And basically, there you have it. But what I will say is this guy's been fantastic, man. I'm telling you. He's 9 years of age, and another 5 years, but I fear for my job.
You fear for your job?
I fear for my job, I do.
Have you enjoyed yourself today? There's one thing I want to say about Dave is not only is he good with wood.
Yeah.
I like that.
Good with wood.
Not only is he good with wood, but he wears the baggy trousers as well. And as far as I'm concerned, that's all good. Okay, so you've had a fantastic day, but that's not it yet. Okay, now he does a lot of woodwork in his front room. He creates a lot of mess, which is very difficult for mother.
Yeah.
Is it a lot of mess?
Quite a lot.
Right, and obviously he cleans it up, doesn't he? I mean,
it's usually me.
He doesn't. Okay, so you'll be pleased to know that we've bought him a saw.
Oh, brilliant.
That he'll have to use in, you know, in the company of his dad, but also some drill bits just to make some extra mess.
Sorry.
But there is a mini vacuum in there as well. Mini vacuum. So there you go, Dave.
Thank you, Dave.
Thanks a lot for taking part, all right? I hope you've had a good day and everything. It's all been good.
I'll bring a big round of applause for this.
A round of applause from everybody. Now, we're coming back to you, Steve, but before we do exactly, I just need to ask you, you know, as much as I enjoy these things coming out of the studio and stuff, you've got Britney Spears, you've got my girls, the Honeyz, you have Diana Ross, Emma Bunting, girl power up in the studio, and I get Handy Andy. Cheers,
I'm sorry, mate. Some of us are just very lucky indeed. That's all I can say. Excellent. Actually, before you go, Andy.
Yes.
I think, have you forgotten something, mate?
I've forgotten something.
Yeah, hang on. How about this? Have you forgotten one of these? Because then, it's a hammer, you see. Because then, right, you could say to yourself, if I had a hammer, yeah? Have a look at this. Have a look.
I'll hammer in the morning. I'll hammer in the evening. All over this land. I'll hammer out danger.
Yes!
I'll hammer out a warning.
Give a round of applause, Handy Andy! Breaking into the music business! business there. Andy, thank you very much for being such a good sport.
No problems.
All right, take care, Otis. Cheers, Dave.
Ta-ra, mate.
Bye. There you go. Fantastic. That was a cool. We got your number, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Hey.
Yes.
Now, the next week, we're going to find out how Aaron Morgan got on when he went training with the one and only David Beckham. Oh, yes. Now, if you would like to make someone's dream come true, tell us why at this address. It's We've Got Your Number, P.O. Box 8181.
We've got your number.
Late as ever again, London W12 6LA. Yes, indeed. Number. Thank you very much. Right, OK. After all that madness, let's calm down a little bit. Watch a few pop videos, shall we? Here's Emma with Hit Miss or Maybe.
That record from Handy Andy was never released, actually. It escaped. There we go, thumbs down. Is it a hit? Is it a miss? Is it a maybe? Let's find out with three toppity-poppity new bits and three toppity-poppity stars. First up, it's my honey bunny from Honeyz. It's Mariama. Next up, a man who flies without wings occasionally from Westlife is Shane. And what I am is what you want to be. Here's the lovely Emma Bunton. And holding it all together, another Emma. Emma Ledden.
Thank you, Mick. Yes, I hope I am holding it together. Welcome to Hit, Miss, and Maybe, everybody. Can I say, three very eager celebrities are sitting here with the things going. I'm ready now, I'm ready. I want three celebrities to predict whether our videos are going to be a hit, a miss, or a maybe. But before that, we have to decide if any of you three are worthy of the title of Video Afghan. But I'm getting deja vu of the first show because it's not here. It broke on the first one and it's not here on this one. Mitch? Where's the Afghan?
Yes. Oh, the Afghan. You know? The leprechauns. The leprechauns have stolen it.
Sorry, we're just trying things in the dark.
You better bring that back right now.
Have you got a tyre lever?
Please.
I told you.
You better bring that back.
For sake.
Bring it back.
There's no control. Bring no control. This week it is D for duets on our Video Afghan. So see how many you can recognise. Grab a pen and paper. You already have. Take it away, Mitch.
Okay, here's five clips of famous duets. See if you can name them.
I hope that second one wasn't too hard for you. Pens down, pens down. No, pens.
I haven't got long.
Emma. Oh, no!
Hey.
That's really always fun. One. There's always one. We'll have the results of those later on. But Mitch, who is up first?
Okay, first video. The first cab off the rank today is the five boys who've moved into one of those new loft-style apartments. But they bought one without a wall. Oh, never trust estate agents. They'll sell you anything. Anyway, here's they are being a bit more poppier than of late. And watch out some rather fine eyebrow raising in this song. Keep on moving. Feeling better things are coming my way. The sunshine has a meaning. It's telling me not to let things get in my way. When the rainy days are dying, gotta keep on trying. All the bees and birds are flying. Never let go, gotta hold on in. Non stop till the break of dawn in. Keep moving, don't stop rocking. Get on up. When you're down, baby, take a good look around. I know it's not much, but it's okay. We'll keep on moving on anyway. Feels like I should be screaming, trying to get it through to my friends. Sometimes it feels like life has no meaning, but I know things will be alright in the end.
One, two, three, four, five. Mitch, you were saying that these guys have never had a number one.
Don't think so, no. Yeah, I think they're looking for their first number one.
Their attempt at it. No, they've never had a number one. Mariama, what do you think of five?
I like that video. I think it's very bright and very colourful. It's a lot different from the songs that they usually do.
The song is different, but the video's quite the same, don't you?
Yeah, the video's quite similar, yeah.
No, they look very sexy all dancing around.
They look quite fine in that video, don't they, actually, I must say.
Not bad.
Yeah, it's nice to see the ones that don't do as much coming up in that song.
And it is very different for five. I don't think it sounds like five, you know, the rest of five.
I wouldn't know if I hadn't seen the video. I wouldn't know it was there.
It's five. So you like that one?
Yeah, I do.
Brilliant. Shane?
I think it's a brilliant video. I think it's a great song. It's different, as she said, it's different from the last one. But definitely.
Think it's better than the others, or just?
I think it's different. I think Sean's voice is really good. It's different, really, like, cool in it. But I think it's a big song, definitely.
Brilliant. Emma!
I think it's very good too. Yeah, I like that.
So we're all in a unanimous.
We're all
very good. Right, you like that one. Grab your hands, everybody. We'll find out whether it's going to be a hit, a miss, or a maybe for five. Mariama, hit, a miss, or a maybe. A hit. Shane, a hit. And Emma. Go on. It's a hit. Hopefully they're first number one for five and keep on moving. We definitely think it's a hit. Mitch, who's up next?
Okay, here's a band that sound like what they always used to, actually, as if they've never been away. A fine band, Madness, from the new album. And this is the life story of a bloke called Johnny the Horse. That he'd go far if he applied his time. But he started out standing on corners and talking out loud, too loud. You see, he couldn't believe in himself or the world or anything he heard. It seems a million years ago that he left his life behind. The moment came for him to go. He said goodbye to his wife and child. Started out walking, he never looked back. There was too much pain between Glasgow and London. One hot summer he forgot his name. Can you remember his name? Can you remember his name? Can you remember? He started out standing on corners and talking out loud, too loud. You see, he couldn't believe in himself or the world or anything he had. Can you remember his name? Can you remember his name?
We're getting excited on Hit, Miss, and Maybe!
We love Madness!
We love that
madness.
One. Okay, sit down. Calm down.
Emma.
All right, Madness. Who is a Madness fan? Absolutely the nearest I've ever come to. I had a boyfriend who liked Madness once. Okay, anyway. I know. Not very
I'm
good,
a Madness
is it?
Fan.
You are, well, Shane, first, you tell me whether you like them. I'm going to drop
I think the video is a bit mad, all right?
Mad for Madness.
The song's quite cool, though, yeah.
Yeah?
Do well, yeah.
And did you, I mean, have you been a fan of Madness?
I remember that song.
Are you a bit young?
I might be a bit young, yeah.
A bit young.
What was the song? What was it?
Welcome to the house of fun. Now we're at our age. Welcome to the house of fun.
That was a great song.
That was a great relationship.
Big fan of that.
Go on, Emma.
I really like Madness. Actually, my family in Ireland are big fans of Madness. So I love them.
You like that one?
Yeah. Cool. And I bought a door, Hits Under the Hammer, for charity. Madness.
Brilliant. And did you like the video? Kind of a strange video. I don't know if we didn't show it all, but it kind of goes through the life of Johnny the Horse. We were, weren't we?
Sorry, I didn't see that.
It is a good video. Mariama, what did you think?
I do like that.
You like that as well?
Very cool video.
They're
I can't help but laugh when I see their videos. Every one of them
is
laughing. Yeah.
I know. Okay, grab your hands. Will it be a hit, a miss, or a maybe from Madness? That's on their comeback album, that song. Mariama, Hit, Miss, or Maybe. It's a hit, Shane. A maybe? Emma.
I love them, but I'm going to give them a maybe.
Why a maybe when you love them?
Because...
Explain yourself, Quentin.
It's not a really poppy, is it?
You don't rightly know, do you?
I don't rightly
know. We don't rightly know. It is a maybe. We don't. Mitch, do you like that one?
Yeah, I like Madness. They're like good songs. Yeah.
Okay.
You're all wrong. You don't know anything. You're all wrong. It'll be a hit. Okay, now next, you'll know this next song, but this is a 26-year-old tenor. And the last time I saw a 26-year-old tenor was when our boss, Chris Bellinger, opened his wallet once and off to buy us a drink. Hey! Anyway, this 26-year-old is Russell Watson with a rugby anthem, a funked-up version. It gets funky later. On of Swing Law, Sweet Chariot.
Little fish cardboard box kind of a
tip. Yeah.
I believe that's the anthem of the Rugby World Cup. What is rugby?
Rugby? Yeah. It's just an excuse for a punch-up, isn't it?
So I believe. Is it like football? Emma, what did you think of that one?
you know, it's fun. I think it's going to obviously be a hit because the lads would be singing it, won't they?
Yeah. So, are you a rugby fan?
No, hate it.
Yeah, me too. Okay, Mary-Emma, what did you think of that one?
My mummy always said, if you have nothing nice to say, don't say anything at all.
That does not apply in this show. This does not apply in this show. We want it all. Dish the dirt. Do you like that one?
I'm not sure about the mix between the opera and the...
All these rugby lads just going, you won! No?
It will be. I think it will be a big hit, though. Yeah, it's not your rugby thing. Yeah.
Okay, Shane. A rugby fan?
I'm a big rugby fan.
You're the man of the group.
Yeah.
You're the man.
I used to play rugby, so I'm a big rugby fan. So I definitely
can do an L tackle and...
Oh, yeah, do the whole works. Yeah.
Do you hear that? Shane can tackle.
No.
Come on. So did you like that one?
Yeah, I did like it. Yeah, it's going to be a big dance show in the clubs and everyone in England's going to go mad for it, so...
Okay,
yeah.
Grab your hands. Will it be a hit, a miss, or a maybe for Russell Watson? What a pop star name. Okay, Mariama, hit, miss, or maybe? A maybe. Shane, a hit. Hey. And Emma...
A hit for all them lads out there.
Which makes it a hit for our rugby anthem. Yay. A hit. Yay. No, you're not getting excited about Russell Watson at all. Yeah. All right, Mitch, the answer's to our video Afghan. Okay, it was D for duets.
Yes, it was D for duets. Poor old Russell Watson, he can't excite you. Here's the first one, then. It was George Michael and Mary J. Blige. And this song was the old Stevie Wonder song, As. Now ain't that love might recognise someone in this video, Bryan Adams and Mel C, and When You're Gone. Here's Brandy, and here's Monica, and here's The Boy Is Mine. This was Faith Evans with Puff Daddy, and I'll Be Missing You. Things in life are free, apparently, at Luther Vandross. And Janet Jackson is this final one.
Okay, Emma, now I know you were saying you didn't have enough time to write, but you did get 6 out of 10. So well done to you. Shane, it was the look of the Irish, I tell you. 7.5 out of 10 for you, well done. But our winner of our video Afghan this week is Maria. They knew it, they're sitting there going, I know you won. 9.5 out of 10 for the I don't know where you lost it.
I'm so sorry, Em. Careful.
That's
all that we could get off the arm.
I don't
stick it on the stump and
award
the thing. You'll be fine.
Big clap, round of applause for the honey of the video. Woo! We'll try and get you the rest of it. I mean, you wanted it, didn't we? Get you the rest of it.
I think the loser should win.
Yeah.
No, but actually, do you know what? You will really enjoy what we've got next because we have a very special treat of the week, don't we? I was watching this, it's brilliant.
We've got a lovely tribute band for you, Emma, for the Spice Girls. Look at this fantastic tribute band that we found, and look how realistic the guy that's playing you looks. Just from the videotape. It's a guy called Ronan Keating. Taking it too easy, but that's the
way it is. What do you think about that? Well, you know how I feel.
Hey, my love, are you for real?
Are you for real?
See, you can't tell the difference. It's fantastic.
Shane, you let this man manage you.
I know.
It's very scary.
What was I thinking?
Emma, what did you think of that?
I think they're brilliant. Actually, we
did you know
there
that... When did they do that? Did you know?
We were there that day that they did that. They're always up for a laugh, and I love the boys. They're great.
Go on, boys. Well, listen, thank you guys so much. Mariama, Shane, and, of course, Emma Bunton, Mitch, and myself. That was Hit, Miss, and Maybe. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you. See you again next week.
Oh yes, here we are, ready for Blobby's Bee Stretch. You know, he has gone bee mad today. He has gone bee mad because the honeys are in. Look at his menu, look. Bee burger and chips. This is quite good actually, isn't it? Honey, I shrunk the sprouts because the honey. Bees and custard. It's awful. He's obsessed. He's even actually dressed as a bee this morning. He's such a... What are you doing? Oi!
Oi! Ow! He's got a sting! Ow! Oi! Stop! Stop pollinating everything! Mr. Blobby! Mr. Blobby! Stop it! Stop pollinating everything! Listen, let's leave you to wind down a little bit. There we go. Someone swat him, please. I'm gonna call our winner. Please stop. Please stop. I'm gonna call our winner. Mitch, this is your chance to say something funny once again.
No, I haven't got any more funny jokes. I've done one joke this week.
Really?
You just turned me on like a tap.
Mr. Biffy! Here we go. Stop it, I'm on the phone. Shh.
Hello?
Hello, is that Paul Evans?
Yeah.
Paul, hello, it's Steve on Live and Kicking. You're live on BBC One! Yeah. Paul, you've been chosen to play Blobby's Bistro. How do you feel?
I just feel like...
That sounds good enough for me. Yeah. What do you think Mr. B looks like? Get it, Mr. B? What do you think he looks like?
Good.
A bit silly?
Yeah.
Well, see, he's got the most horrible antennae that are whipping me on the head at the moment. Can you... Oh, it's all right. Come on, I'm only joking. Anyway, so are you ready to play Blobby's Bistro?
Yeah.
Okay, let me tell you what's happening. Mr. B is going to have 20 seconds to move around the bistro and try and rip off all the tablecloths, because underneath there are fruit, and the fruit mean prizes. So, Mitch, can you tell us what the prizes are today, please?
Okay, if you find a prickly pear, you win the fantastic limited edition Blobby Gnome, handcrafted by the famous artist Julian Van de Prop Department. And that's a very desirable thing. If you find a super strawberry, you win prize number two, which is this rather nice, funky side watch. And if you find the top banana, we'll give you the star prize, a new invention called a television. Good luck.
Fantastic, thank you. Do you know what? I should actually make sure that you're worthy to play as well, shouldn't I, Paul? Can you tell me who the dish of the day was? Have a look. Who do you think this is? Who do you think? Who's that?
David Beckham.
Yes, it's David Beckham. Here's what you instantly win. Thank you very much, Simon. This is what you instantly win. It's the Live and Kicking Fleece, okay? That's for you.
Thank you.
And also the Miss It Miss Out wallet as well. Now we can play. Those are the prizes. And I tell you what, there's a booby prize as well, and it's a bee. And I'm not quite sure what happens, but we'll have to work out. Stop pollinating things, Mr. Blobby. All right, look, let's have to... Are you ready to root for the fruit, Mr. Blobby?
Yes!
Yeah? Fruit, are you ready to root for the fruit?
Yes!
People over here, are you ready to root for the fruit?
Yes!
Fantastic. Right, okay, here we go. 20 seconds on the clock. Good luck, Paul. 3, 2, 1. Come on, Mr. Blobby. Oh, nothing there. Come on, move. Where are you going to go? Nope, nothing there. Come on. Come on, Mr. B. Come on.
Come on, Blobby.
No, there's nothing there either. Come on.
Don't fuck
around. Oh, no, nothing there. That's the booby prize. No. Oh, quick. Mr. B, keep going, quickly. Over here. Yes. Yeah. That was it. We got it on the zero.
Yeah.
Have a look. It's the banana. It's the top banana. Bring on the fruit. You got the star prize just in time there, I will say, Paul. Well done, Mr. B. Mitch, what does he win? What does he win?
He wins that fantastic telly thing, which you can watch telly on. Hooray.
Fantastic. Are you happy, Paul?
Yeah, very happy.
You are fantastic. All right, enjoy your prize and have
a
good rest of your day. Take care.
Can I have a Diana Ross's autograph, please?
Of course you can. Take care.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
There you go. Now, Mr. B.
Yeah.
I'm glad you got the dish of the day.
Yeah.
Can you do that thing when you really rattle it really hard? You know, like sometimes when you go, yeah. But no, harder than that. Go on. Much harder. That's it. Now take the lid off. Yeah. Now take the lid off. There you go. Let's see.
Badly animated computer graphics can't sting you. Haha, now Emma Bunton has become the world famous as Baby Spice after 3 years and 7 number one hits. The Spice Girls have also notched up 2 celebrity weddings, 3 solo singles and 2 spicy babies. But none of these have involved Emma until now. This month sees the launch of her new TV series and her first solo single, What I Am. We reckon Emma's got loads more surprises up her sleeve to come, so let's find out this morning as we say good morning and welcome to Live and Chatting.
Yeah. Welcome to Live and Chatting, everybody. The one and only, she's been here all morning, Miss Emma Bunton.
Yes!
Emma, love to have you. I've had so many calls. calls. It's been such a busy show. So many calls and questions. So I'm going to go straight to the phone.
Fine.
To line one. Hello, who's on line one?
Hi, it's Stefan from Tunbridge.
Hello, Stefan. What's your question for Emma?
Hello, Emma.
Hi.
Do you consider the other Spice Girls rivals in the charts?
Sorry, what was that?
Do you consider
the other Spice Girls rivals in the charts?
No, not at all, not at all. I think there's this whole thing at the moment about rivalry. I think music is about fun. And, you know, there's loads of artists out there, which I'm sure all these people like, every single one of them. Uh-huh. And I think, you know, it should be made fun and enjoyable.
Absolutely. Wise words there.
Thank you, Stefan.
Okay, Joe, in the studio, you have a question? Hi, Joe.
If you could have any other nickname, what would it be?
I don't know.
Did you pick Baby Spice?
No, I didn't, actually. A magazine gave me the name. But what would you think? Have you got an idea?
Or if you could be any other Spice Girl, what Spice name would you have? Would you be scary, or would you be posh, or would you be...
I think I'd try and be sporty. I'd try, but I don't think it would work very well.
That sounds like me, really.
All right, back to the phones. Line two. Hello, who's on line two?
Hello, it's Jane from London.
Hello, Jane. What's your question for Emma?
Hi, Jane.
Hello, I was just wondering, is the Spice Girls going to be splitting up?
Are the Spice Girls going to be splitting up?
No, not at all. We're at the moment working on our third album, which is going really well. We've got gigs at Christmas, and then we're hoping to tour again next year. So there's lots more coming from us.
What are the rest of the girls up to at the moment?
At the moment, they're working on their solo projects, and obviously Victoria and her baby, and she's doing some bits of acting and stuff. But we're back next week, actually, rehearsing for our Christmas gigs.
Brilliant.
Excellent. Thank you, Jay. Is there any chance of a Christmas number one again?
Oh, there has to be. It wouldn't be Christmas without one.
I think we're going to be too busy with the album and the gigs. But I hope we don't let too many.
Okay. Let's let someone else have a question. Rose in the studio. Hi, Rose. What's your question?
Hi, Rose. Hi, Emma. Do you ever feel under pressure to make your solo career as great as the Spice Girls story?
Oh, definitely not. I think, you know, with my solo project, it's just fun. I'm enjoying it. You know, Tintin out at a great band, and they asked me to come and sing on this track. For me, Spice Girls is priority and always will be. And then, you know, the other bits I do is just fun and something that I want to try.
Excellent.
Brilliant. Okay, back to the phones. Line three.
Hello, it's Laura Mackie from Coventry.
Hello, Laura. What's your question for Emma?
Hi, Emma. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
All right, thanks.
Good.
Who's your role model and why?
Who's your role model?
My role model is my mother. She's here today.
Aww.
Where's mum? Where's mum?
No, don't get around.
Where's mum? Give us a wave, mum.
Big wave. There she is.
There she is.
She don't look here.
Come on, camera two.
Camera two, go to the last one.
There you go.
Hey. Mummy's fine.
That's
my mummy. She's just below. She's all shy now, poor thing. She's just a very strong woman. I mean, I was, you know, brought up as a single, you know, parent, and she's just very, very lovely.
Do you bring her everywhere with you?
Yeah, I do, actually. Yeah. Well, most places. Sometimes she goes, can I come? I'm like, no!
We're close to our mums, too.
Very. My mum was here. She's just gone.
Oh, good.
Christopher in the studio now. Christopher, hiya.
Hello, Dad. What's in store for the Spice Girls in the future?
As
I said before, we've got our album coming out, which is going to be out next year, and we're hoping to tour again next year, so there's lots, and then obviously another album, and maybe more babies.
But you're still together, and there's
loads more to come. We've been having a great time this year. We're really, really strong at the moment.
Brilliant. Okay, back to the phones. Line four. Who's on line four?
Sean from Gravesend.
Hello, Sean. What's your question for Emma?
What's worse, flying in an airplane to different countries all the time, or being away from your family?
What's worse, being away from my family. I miss them lots when I'm away, and it's just, you know, the little things you miss. You know, your bedroom and
your couch.
Yeah, and your dogs and, you know, just things like that. You miss that.
Are you getting to be at home a bit more now?
Yeah, definitely. I'm home quite a lot now, which is nice. And but I'm sure I'll be travelling again soon.
Excellent. Okay. Quick question from Letty in the studio.
If you could have a career other than singing, what would it be?
Cool.
I think I'd like to make cakes.
What sort of cakes?
Any cakes will do me fine.
Would they be to sell or just for you to eat?
Well, I'd have to sell them, I suppose, for the money, but then I could eat them as well. So.
Do you know what? I'd go along with that.
Yeah? Okay, we'll do that together.
And I can't sing, so I'll definitely go along with that. Making cakes. But listen, thank you so much, Emma, for being on Live and Shining. Give it up for Emma. Your brand new singer for us right now. So go on, off you go.
Go join
the
band,
girl. It's
excellent.
Fantastic.
Thank you. Cheers, Emma. Well, that's it for another show. I tell you what, I've got to thank all the guests. They've been brilliant today. We've had such a lineup. Who have we had? That's a bit early. That music, isn't
it? Hang on, just a second.
Thank you very much to Diana Ross for coming in, the legend.
The legend. Britney Spears was in the house today. Westlife.
Yeah. Thank you very much to the Honeyz as well. And also Otis, Handy Andy and David at our outdoor broadcast. Thanks, guys.
Woohoo! Next week, we've got another fantastic show. We've got stars from Casualty, we've got Shauna Lowry, and we've got music from Eternal.
Yes,
that's not all.
That's not all. I'll tell you what, on next week's show, we've also got this. You're not going to believe it. Oh.
I told my sister my dream was to train with David Beckham. I wrote into Live and Kicking to see if I could make his dream come true.
How could I resist? Watch us next week on Live and Kicking.
With her brand new single, it is Tin Tin Out featuring Emma Bunton, and What I Am is absolutely fantastic. We had a great show.
We've had a brilliant show. We had a good, fantastic show. Read all about it in the November issue of the BBC Live and Kicking magazine.